This group of wildlife enthusiasts is setting up trap cameras in Mumbai's Aarey milk colony, a 1,300-acre forested area right next to the Sanjay Gandhi National Park, which is home to the highest density of leopards anywhere in the world. 41 leopards live here, according to the most recent census in February 2018. In 2017, Mumbai witnessed over 7 attacks by leopards, the highest in 15 years. Most of them took place in and around Aarey colony, home to the Warli tribals. The group's efforts in monitoring the leopards in Aarey colony paid off when the forest department was able to capture the animal based on their inputs.
We have started doing camera trapping in Aarey from like more than three years now. So the main intention of doing this was to gather a data. We wanted to understand, see, we have observed that whenever there is a conflict, the forest department earlier used to set the trap cages and trap the animal, but they were not sure whether the same animal was responsible for conflict or not. Basically, we used two kind of cameras, one is IR and one is with flash. So we had to install these camera traps at a location where there is a frequent movement of animal. That is, after an animal breaks the bream, it will trigger after 5 seconds. So these cameras basically, they take color pictures in the night, and during daytime they take videos as well as pictures. Having color pictures is an added advantage because it helps in identifying the animal. If we don't install it properly, there are chances that we might get images, but those are half images. You might just get a head of a leopard.
In 2016, a member of the group, Nayan Khanolkar, was named Photographer of the Year by the National History Museum, London, for a photograph of a leopard in a narrow lane in Aarey colony, taken with a trap DSLR camera. With a density of over 20,000 people per square kilometer, Mumbai is also one of the most populated places on Earth. Man-animal conflict is difficult to avoid, especially with the ever-shrinking forest cover in Aarey colony due to illegal encroachments and various urban infrastructure projects. March 20, 2017. In the first attack reported that year, 3-year-old Pranay Rinjad was rescued literally from the jaws of a leopard.
Early 2017, we got a call that there has been a leopard attack on a kid who is like 2 years old. Basically, the leopard jumped on him and his mom was there. So she just went back and she shouted, and like, so the leopard went back. But he had grabbed the kid, so he had got like marks, nail marks, and like, I think so, jaw. That's where we thought, okay, now this leopard is quite bold, because we had got information he is walking in front of the bike. Then we spoke with the forest department, then we started putting more camera traps in that area. After like a month, we got another report saying that there is one more attack. So basically in 6 to 7 months, there were like 5 attacks.
The first task of the trappers was to identify the leopard.
Whenever we get an image of leopard, so you can see there are spots on leopard which are called as rosette, and every rosette pattern of each and every individual leopard is different.
May 2017, a 3-year-old girl's body is discovered after she had gone missing 2 days earlier. She was suspected to be killed by a leopard. On 22nd July 2017, 2-year-old Vihan Nilesh Garuda, son of a Sanjay Gandhi National Park staffer, was picked up by a leopard in front of his parents in broad daylight near the film city. The parents free him from the leopard's grip and take him to the hospital, but he is declared dead on arrival.
We started putting up the camera traps in different areas where we knew this suspected animal will go, and that is his territory. But like the prime territory over here, we had installed CCTV camera traps because we wanted to monitor which animal is going near the cage, and we didn't want the innocent animal to go. Every day night after like 7 p.m. we used to sit there till 5 in the morning, and we start monitoring it. Some of our guys from the group will go to a different location in the night. Just they do a patrolling. The mission went for like 40 days, and after 40 days we trapped him into Film City. Once we, Imran, Mayur and Ranjit went to Film City in the night, and they saw a leopard. And they started following the leopard. They were clicking pictures and photos basically to identify which animal it is. So we came to know that this is Regulus, and that time we came to know that this part of Film City is also his territory, which we didn't knew before. And then we decided immediately that we have to shift one bait trap over there to trap him. And we shifted that trap, and in 2 days, Regulus was trapped there.
The group hopes their data can be useful to scientists and wildlife experts to understand the behavior of these wild cats living in close proximity to humans.